Welcome back, everybody, to Let's Play Super Metroid, and something important has come to my attention. And that's the fact that you can't get the best ending in the game unless you beat it under 3 hours. Notice our time. 2.5 hours. So, you know what this means, don't ya? It means speedrun time. That's what we're gonna do. Why do I have more? Oh, right. I was gonna say something. But yeah, I'm gonna go into a speedrunning mode. I'm still gonna be like live commentating, but I'm gonna do this as fast as I can. I've practiced this twice now. I think I got it down. I should know where to go, what to do. I went ahead and just took the elevator down to Norfair. It takes less than a minute to get from the save point that we were at to this save point. Like, seriously, less than a minute, so, you're not missing out on too much. Anyways, we're gonna take a shortcut over to the thing, and we're gonna go and fight a boss, which will unlock the door to the final boss. So, let's see how well we can do this. I have done speed runs and stuff of, like, other Metroid games, like Metroid Prime. I can beat Metroid Prime 100% in just under 5 hours, which is pretty good considering, you know, it's definitely longer than this game. But, we're gonna see. I just did a practice where I died to, the final boss. But I don't. That'll happen again. Also, I keep thinking that I have a thing that we don't have yet. Just run into enemies. Whatever. There's a couple of energy restore places. So up, wrong way. You see, I said I got this down, but do I really? Apparently not. Gonna have to go all the way down here. I'm just gonna keep the power bombs equipped because, let's grab a few more. Because there's a lot of power bomb places. So, when you got the gravity suit, you can actually not get hurt by lava, which is pretty cool. Unfortunately, you can still get hit by these guys, which is why they're here. There we go. I thought I was gonna fall again. That would have been terrible. Anyways, just take the elevator, and we go to a part of the game called Lower Norfair, and it's got so much awesome music. This music was also in Metroid Prime, if you saw my LP of that, and I thought we were gonna go through this room without too much of a problem, but whatever. It's not that big of a deal. And that is not normal lava, that will actually hurt you. So, powerbomb here. And there's a Chozo statue, which will drain the lava. Didn't want to spoil it, but I mean, it's like 1 second, so. Anyways, now we can go down here. I know I'm gonna miss like a lot of power-ups and stuff, but what I'm gonna do is, it's gonna be like an extra episode, or an extra couple episodes, depending on how you guys want it. Some people want, like a speed up video of me getting all the power ups, and some people want me to do it like this. So we'll just have to see. Whoops. But, we got this guy here. And, all we have to do is use our charge beam for the most part. And you can use missiles, but I want to save my missiles, so. He's given us some, so. You know what? I'm gonna use one. Or a bunch. He does give us a couple when he dies, so Might as well speed up the process and whatnot. Yeah. He gave us enough. So, that works out alright. That was just like a little mini boss. Anyways, we got the screw attack. Also, it was also seen in the previous two Metroid games. And in some Metroid games, it's paired up with the space jump, and you don't get the space jump separate, you just get them both at the same time. Which, I guess that's cool. They didn't do it with this game, but this was... Actually, it wasn't the first game to have the space jump. It was Metroid 2, which is probably the least played Metroid game. Like, even more so than, like, Metroid Other M, because Metroid Other M is $5 now. Which is kind of weird, because you'd expect people, like, to be more into that game, like, general audience people, because it's a lot more, like, mainstream, and it, like, it's super linear. I don't know. I really liked Metroid Other M, but, it wasn't very Metroid-like at all, which is why pretty much nobody else liked it. But I thought it was okay. Anyways, we go down here, and we're gonna have to do some fancy stuff here, fancy space jumping. And that went pretty well. Let's hope things continue to go well. And, actually, we don't want to do that just yet. Oh, I bet I just wasted a power bomb. Whatever. Whoop. Stupid me just falling. Anyways, definitely want to go down here to get an energy tank. This will definitely help for both the final boss and Ridley. Spoilers, Ridley's in this game. But, it's kind of obvious. This is not only called Lower Norfair, it's also called Ridley's Lair. So, I mean, I don't know. What were you expecting? You guys were expecting something. I mean, who doesn't know, like, at least something about this game? I don't know. Just grabbing a few things here and there. Super missiles will be very useful. Just gotta make sure to hurry it up here. I sorta know what I'm doing. Sorta. Let's see. And we can just jump over here. I guess we'll waste a power bomb. And another one. These guys mostly don't give you anything, so... There we go. And I hate this room so much, you have no idea. Maybe you guys hate this room too. I'd imagine that. Anyways, a super missile door. I think that's the last one in the game, actually. So, these guys, they're annoying. You gotta shoot them. And then get them to jump at you. Come on. Come on. Come on, really? You gotta be kidding me. Yeah, these guys, I hate these guys so much. There we go, and yep, there is a second one. This guy should be easier. I don't know, for some reason the second one's always easier. I don't know why or how, but that's how they made it. Easier. And this is the perfect room for getting a couple power-ups. You want to be at full health for this if you don't have like a lot of energy tanks like I do. I mean, I guess there are a lot, but it's not like a I have as many as I could get. I could technically get, like, every energy tank in the game except for one. There's one I can't get until I beat this boss. I'm just gonna refill. We need everything we can get. They need all the firepower they can get. As they say, pistols for pandas, which is a hilarious cartoon. Not a series, but it's a single cartoon. It's not married. Whatever. I'm just being weird. Anyways, more Ridley. This time, we can beat him and he can beat us, unlike last time. And I know there's gonna be some people who are like good at this game, and I guess I'm alright at this game, but there's gonna be people who are like, you're doing terrible. I'm sure they would have found a way to beat him by now. Come on now. A good method is to, well, not do what I'm doing. Careful of the tail. He can't hurt you when you're doing the screw attack, so, if he's getting near you, just screw attack towards him, and it should push him back. Unless the screw attack doesn't work for some reason. Should be mostly dead. I don't know, he's got a lot of health. It's kind of ridiculous, actually. Get away from me. Yeah, this technique works pretty well. As long as you're good at the screw attack. There we go. I'm not doing great. I'll say that. Come on. Urgh. You fool. Die. Come on. Alright, and this is the part where we panic. Or not. Yeah, sometimes he dies after he grabs you, and I don't know why. It's kind of weird. But anyways, we go in here, and the baby Metroid is gone. Well, that's nice. At least we got an energy tank out of it, and at least we know that Ridley doesn't have it because he's dead. Again. Somehow this happens. I don't think there's any other power-ups in here, so we're just gonna forget about that. And now we can make our way to the final boss. So, that's awesome, right? Alright, it's been 13 minutes. I guess 10 minutes in-game, so we've got 20 minutes to beat the game. That's not a lot of time, considering how far away we are from everything. This could be a real deal-breaker, just this room could really just ruin everything. Well, there we go. I guess that wasn't too bad. There we go. I'm glad I fixed that select button. Wait a second, I didn't know there was a room over there. Oh right, yeah, that's just a power up. So, yeah. I looked at the map in my mind, and I was just like, I know what that is. And that's how the brain works. Sometimes. Sometimes your brain doesn't know what's going on. Crap. I didn't... Okay. Yeah. There is a limit on how fast you can put those power bombs down. But now we have to head all the way back to our ship, which shouldn't take too long. It'll only take a minute, really. Gotta go through this room. And the blue fireballs can hurt you while you're doing the screw attack in lava, but if you're doing in air, it doesn't. I went the wrong way again. Nice job speedrunning there. I'm gonna have to get like really good at this game later on. You'll guys see what I mean by that. But I'll be needing to get better. Anyways, this room hurts. At the speed of hurts. I don't know. Stupid commercials. Getting in my head, messing stuff up. That's how commercials work.